Thank you. May I ask Abhinav to throw the floor open for questions from the audience?
Hi. Hello. My name is Preksha. So I wanted to ask that patriarchy doesn't just...
I think you can stand up for your rights.
I wanted to ask that patriarchy doesn't just affect women, it affects men too. And when we talk he for she, we don't talk about he for he or she for she, because women are also, you know, do become enemies of other women. And they do, you know, bring themselves down. So what about women leaders in, say, television?
You know, I think, like you mentioned, Emma Watson, the topic of feminism has always come up. And feminism has today become, people have created their own definition. And the point, the fact that a lot of women don't want to become feminists today, you know, because of the fact that people think probably it gives you like a wrong attitude, it's not feminine enough, you know, it's a manly version. What do you think of the whole...
Well, I mean, I don't know if you can really generalize this, and I can't give you a generalized answer to this. I think everybody has their own reasons for choosing to be a certain way or believing in certain or in a certain way or a certain way of being. But the fact is that someone has mentioned that today probably is a time for men to be a lot more feminist than women need to be. You know, so and also just to answer a little bit of what the lady earlier asked, you know, I think in a patriarchal society what happens is that men, I think just by on the basis of their gender, always have goodwill ambassadors which are their parents. You know, it's the daughters who need goodwill ambassadors more often than not. So, in itself, so I do agree there's many problems in terms of what you were talking about vis-a-vis what women can do for women, what women can do for men. But the fact is that there is a huge need of the hour for men to do something for women in this country.
Just another question. You'd like to add, ma'am? Please go ahead.
So the fact of the matter is that there are few male actors who get paid more than most male actors as well. You know? So maybe we should change that as well, you know? So.
I think there's a supplementary to that for in the sense that the portrayal of women in entertainment has also changed over the last few years. I mean, there are some directors and some producers who've acted positively. And there's positive affirmative action. But on the other hand, there's also objectification of women, which rightly and rightly the society and, you know, parents, I have a six-year-old, for instance, and I don't switch on television in the evening because I don't know what next will come on. So
what it is that their children are watching. But again, like you said, that there are certain filmmakers who are a lot more aware, a lot more responsible towards what it is that they're putting out as content. And there are some who are not. Hopefully those people will realize that the audience has changed and they don't want that anymore. But it's weirdly, I mean, unfortunately, it's a kind of a demand and supply kind of business. You know, so till something doesn't become obsolete in terms of people demanding it, there'll always be someone who will create it. And apart from the responsibility, I think, of the filmmaker, be it a man or a woman who's making the film, there's also a responsibility of the person who's choosing themselves to be cast in those parts. You know, we never stop to think about why are those people doing it in the first place. You know, so it's their responsibility as well. For me, I can again speak about the films that I make and the content that I put out. And that's something that all of us, be as producers, as writers, me as a director, or when I'm working with others, we're very, very cautious about.
If I could just add, in the entertainment scene and content, one of the areas that we're very concerned about is video games, because there's a lot of video games that encourage violence. A video game that gives a player an option to either beat up a woman or rape a woman, and that game is made available to a seven-year-old. That is quite worrying. It's one of the things that in the He for She campaign would like the He for She's to look into and to try to discourage boys and men to use those games, but even more importantly, to discourage those who produce those games, to produce those games and bring them out into society. I know it makes a lot of money, so it's gonna be tough, but I think this is something that when the numbers go higher and higher, we should be able together to fight back.
Are there any more questions?
Hi, Farhan. This question is for you. According to a recent UN study, six out of ten Indian men have admitted to using violence against their spouse. How soon do you see this changing, and how should people work individually to probably bring about this change?
I think the answer again comes back to what we've been talking about all this while, which is truly educating people about treating each other equally. I think the minute that happens and you feel that, okay, I do not consider myself more powerful than the other person, I do not consider that person weaker than me, you will be forced into dialogue automatically. You know, if you had an argument with your partner in business, and if you were 50% partners, you can't resort to violence to sort it. You'll have to sit down and talk. And it's exactly the same thing. But if that person in your mind was just a 6% owner and 94% was yours, you treat that conversation and that meeting very, very differently. So I think if you start believing in equality, automatically things like violence will start changing.
You are part of the film industry, which treats women reasonably on a fair platform. But there are certain elements who kind of, you know, use derogatory language, put out tweets like a Kamala Khan. How would you react to such people?
I won't retweet him.
My question is for the both of you. You know, another way of looking at it as an issue is like, or, you know, stuff like women's emancipation or women's...
Well, I'm in complete agreement with what's just been said. I think it'll have to be a multi-pronged approach where anything and everything that can be done to make a difference as quickly as possible will have to be tried and will have to be done. So depending on environment, depending on circumstances, I think absolutely at times there will be an intervention required, and at times just encouragement so that a certain goal can be achieved along the way. So it'll have to depend on what it is you're facing.
Ma'am, just another, you know, adding another point to this whole discussion, the ratio of female sterilization in our country is very high compared to that of male as well. You know, when it comes to population control, it's usually they say that, you know, the women are supposed to go and sterilize themselves, and they make it a mandate in a lot of families. Again, would you also like to bring this?
Definitely. We need men to be equal partners in managing in taking the responsibility in managing how the families are growing, what the plan of the family and what the family can afford in terms of the number of children they can have.
Hello, this is Mrinmay from Maharashtra Times. My question is to Farhan, sir. What made you basically join this particular cause? Is it because you have two beautiful daughters? From that point, you thought of giving importance to this particular cause?
Well, I mean, that too. But I also know many other people who have beautiful daughters, you know. I think it's just something that troubled me for a very long time. And unfortunately, for a very long time, I didn't do anything about it. I would just talk to people, you know, in my living room or in their living rooms and kind of vent this anger and frustration that I was feeling about what was happening. But never took any concrete steps towards actively giving time and energy into trying to figure out what it is or how I can be involved. And it came to a point where I really felt that if I didn't do something, it would start really affecting me, which is why it was important that I did.
Thank you.
To you, so there are two questions. One, you've spoken about parameters that you try to give.